Who is Guru? Guru Nanak gave a beautiful answer to this question in one of the lines that he sang. Every Sikh, every person who loves and follows Guru Nanak knows this line. But this line has deep secret. So the line in Punjabi says, Pavan Guru Pani Pita Mata Tarat Mahat. I'll translate this in English. Guru Nanak says, air is your guru. Water is like your father. And this earth on which we live is the great mother. So in this line, he has defined, and this friend had asked, who is a guru? Nanakji says, air is guru. Air that we breathe is guru. Water is like our father, and this great grand earth is our mother. Secret, as I said, this line has a secret. What does Guru Nanak says? What does he mean when he says, air is our guru? What is air? What is air? That which we breathe. So he's really saying that breath is our guru. Look at it carefully. This is extremely important. Guru Nanak is saying, who's our guru? Breath is our guru. Why he's saying breath is our guru? Very beautiful, very beautiful. If you see, we all live in a world of duality. I am separate, you are separate. In our consciousness, that's what we feel. I and you, separation, sense of separation, sense of duality. Right? What is that one thing at that level we are all one? At the level of breath. What one inhales, somebody is exhaling the same air. What you exhale, I inhale. What I exhale, you inhale. We're all connected through breath. At the level of breath, we're all one. There's a great secret. At the level of breath, in our chetana, in our consciousness, in our knowing, at the level of breath, we're all same. We're all one. No matter how rich you are, how poor you are, no matter how evil you are, how godly you are, we're all sharing this air together. So Guru Nanak is saying, at the level of breath, we're all equal. When it comes to breath, all separation goes. Look at another thing about breath. Almost every tradition on earth, every spiritual tradition on earth has said, if you follow the breath, you can reach the ultimate truth. I have yet to see any form of meditation which just does not make use of breath. Yeah, from the Tibetan to Tantric, to ancient Indian, to Vedic, any, if you go to any field of meditation, breath is essential. Yeah. Now why he is saying that breath is our guru? Or why following the breath we can touch the ultimate peak? Why Guru Nanak is saying, look buddy, the breathing, if you can just follow this breathing, you can reach the ultimate reality, ultimate truth. Hence, following the breath, which means following the guru, you can reach the truth that you're seeking. Yeah. How do you follow the breath? What's the secret here? Because when you follow the breath, the in-breath and the out-breath, breath going in, breath coming out, you are in this very moment. By watching the breath, by following the breath, by becoming aware about the breath, you can free yourself of all the mind conditioning, of all the mind content, of all the past baggage which weighs you down, of all the future projections which weighs us down. We can cut all the cords. and be in this moment. Yeah. In the yogic system, we build the entire science of pranayama, watching the breath, manipulating the breath, controlling the breath, following the breath, changing the pattern of the breath, being with the breath. Do you know that if we alter as in pranayama, there are practices, if you alter the movement of your breathing rhythm, if you alter the movement of your breathing rhythm, you can experience amazing states of bliss within. New dimensions can open up, new dimensions of reality can open up just through breathing. It is so powerful. It is so important. Hence, Guru Nanak ji said, breath is your guru. Following which, you can touch the ultimate reality. Following which, you can cut the projections of the future and the burdens of the past. Following which, you can come to the present moment. Following which, you can touch the ultimate ananda of being. Breath is your guru. Life is breath. For a few minutes, if the breathing process stops, we are done. Breath is equated to life. The most important thing that makes us alive is breathing, our guru. Yeah? Hence, Guru Nanak ji said, breathing or breath, which he is saying in his language, pavana, air, is your guru. Yeah? Traveling with the breath, we can go into our inner being. Because when you watch the breath, you come to the present moment. The mind becomes stable. The breathing becomes stable. All the conditioning goes out of the window. In that moment, the inner door starts to open up of our consciousness, of our chetana. We enter into that. Peace, silence, eternal bliss through breath. So that's what Guru Nanak ji said. Pavana Guru, breathing is your guru. Yeah. So the friend asked, who is a guru? Nanak ji answers, breath is your guru. The friend asked the question, do I need a guru? Yes, of course we all need breathing. We all need guru. Again, there is a secret here. Now, to follow or to come back to my breathing, what do I need? What do I need? Now look at it carefully. Now we are entering from Guru Nanak's suggestion to the practical domain. Yeah. Do I need a guru? Yes. Yes, we all need a guru. Not just breath as a guru. We also need a guru, possibly, if it works, in the form, in the world of form, in the world of human form. We constantly need somebody who can inspire us to watch the breath, who can remind us to watch the breath, who can motivate us to watch the breath, who can guide us to watch the breath. Somebody by looking at whom this awareness arises in me that I too can achieve that state of bliss by watching the breath. Do you follow? So to watch my breath, I need a constant remembrance from somebody. Can I do it on my own? Absolutely. You can just be totally aware all the time to watch your own breath, to be with your own inner guru. Yes, but most of the time, look at practical life, look at your own experience. Most of the time, we get engaged with the flow of life. We get entangled with the processes of life. We get entangled with so many thoughts and desires that we have. We build castle in air of our own imagination. Endless loop of desires we live in. From small, from gross to the subtle. That's our living reality, no? In this living reality, yes, we need somebody. We need somebody who can constantly remind us of our purpose here, who can constantly remind us to be connected with the inner guru, who can show us the path. How do I do this practice of connecting to my inner guru, my breathing? Yeah, otherwise we forget. That's the whole problem that we have. We forget things, we forget the reason why we are here. Yeah, the forces of earth or the forces of life, they just grab us. Yeah. So this friend asked, do I need a guru? Yes, we all need a guru. We all need that somebody as a constant reminder. Somebody who can challenge us. Somebody who can show us that we are asleep. Somebody who can show us that we too can be awakened. Somebody who can show us that path. And somebody who can hold our hand to walk with us on that path. On that path of self-remembrance. Yeah. So my answer to this friend is, yes. We all need some kind of a guru. If we can get somebody, if we can find somebody in a human form, it's all the more good. Connection is much more easier then. Yeah.